The flu does not discriminate, but those with autoimmune diseases are at a much higher risk of getting sick.
WUFT sat down with one woman with an autoimmune disease, but as Sophia Molar shows us, that condition does not stop her from living her life to the fullest.
The first thought in Celine Singh's head today, making it to career showcase on time. The last thing on her mind is her disease.
I don't think about those things, and I don't allow myself to do so.
Singh was diagnosed with lupus when she was 13.
If I ever get sick, then my body just attacks everything and anything. So it attacks my good cells, it attacks the virus, it attacks everything.
That Christmas, she spent the whole week in the hospital.
My sister and brother waited to open their Christmas presents until after I got out of the hospital.
Since then, Singh's physicians have kept a close eye on her, especially when she might be at a higher risk, like during flu season.
I usually get my flu shot, and if I don't, then my doctor makes sure that I get my flu shot.
CDC data shows this year's vaccine is only 30% effective, but experts say it's worth getting the shot.
If there is a one-third chance that you're going to have either no flu, or a version that's much, much weaker than what other people are experiencing, then absolutely. I mean, it's something that you should do.
For those with autoimmune disease, catching any kind of illness can quickly turn into a visit to the emergency room.
Physicians advise lupus patients to take extra care of themselves by eating healthy, exercising, and overall keeping their hands clean. So, flu season protocol doesn't really detour their daily routine.
I do yoga, I knit, I love running. Like, those things are a part of my life, and I shouldn't just stop doing those things just because I have a fear of death.
Sophia Molar, WUFT News.
The Lupus Foundation of America says more than 1.5 million people in the U.S. suffer from the autoimmune disease.